Swift packages are awesome in iOS development because they make it easy to manage, share, and reuse code across projects. They streamline dependency management, allowing developers to integrate third-party libraries and tools with just a few clicks. By using Swift packages, you can keep your code base clean and organized, making it simpler to collaborate and maintain. In this video, I'll guide you through the process of creating your own Swift package step by step, empowering you to build modular, reusable code for your iOS projects. So today we are going to create a Swift package, and we just need some code to, you know, distribute in a Swift package, and I just chose the previous video, so go ahead and check that out. It's about network monitoring, and you are going to take a look at the actual code that I have written in the previous episode. So let's just take a look at this. This is the end result. So we are going to turn off Wi-Fi, and it says it's disconnected, and then let's turn it on again, and once it's connected to the internet, now it says connected. This is a really useful feature to have in your application to just basically show the user what's going on, or maybe limit some functionality of your application. And how is this done? Well, we have created an environment called a network, and according to the property of is connected on that environment, we just present different views. Now let's take a closer look at the actual code of the network observer. We just imported network, we create a network monitor, and listen to the changes. That's why we have this path update handler, and start it on the worker queue, so it's not going to interfere with the main queue, right? Basically on that is reserved for the UI. And then out of convenience, we created this entry and this extension on the view, which we are using right over here. This is where we just started, and then we can use it throughout the app. So okay, this is fine, it's inside the application, but I want to use this in all of my projects. I would need to copy and paste. That's not a good thing, of course, because maybe some new stuff comes up and I just update this, and then I have to go in all of my projects and update it. This is where Swift package comes in, and with Swift package manager from Xcode, it's built right into it. We can easily reuse our code through multiple projects. Every iOS developer can experience significant growth with the support of a mentor. A mentor offers personalized guidance, valuable industry insights, and practical solutions to help you navigate the complexities of the iOS ecosystem and accelerate your progress. With customized feedback and expert career advice, a mentor keeps you on track for success. As a developer, I provide one-on-one mentorship tailored to sharpen your skills and help you reach your full potential. Ready to level up a special discounted rate? Visit rebeloper.com/mentoring-offer and begin your journey today. Don't wait, this offer is only available until Halloween. Okay, so how to do this? Well, first of all, we need to create a package. Just go under File, and then select New, and then Package. There we go. And let me just move this a little bit over here so we can see it better. We want to actually create a library for multi-platform. That's perfectly fine. Let's click on Next. And then testing system. We might choose Swift testing or Xcode XC tests. I'm just going to go with none. This is just a small little library. And then let's click on Next, and then just save it wherever you like. Most importantly, what you need to do is just create a Git repository on your Mac, a local version of your code, like versioning of your code, because we need to distribute it this onto GitHub. So, you know, I can access it throughout multiple projects. And of course, this will be public, so even others may use it if they choose to. And then let's give a name. So this should be Network Observer. Let's click on Create right over there. So now we have a local version of this Swift package on our machine. What we need to do is now add some files. So we have this network observer. If you are having more files, then you need to create them. But for now, all I have is just this simple file right over here. So what I'm going to do is just copy everything out. So hit Command A and Command C, switch to the project, the actual Swift package, and just paste it over there. And maybe let's just remove these lines of code. Yeah, it's not about the demo. Okay, so let's see. iOS is only available on macOS 14 or newer. Now, what you want to do is just select right over here any iOS device or simulator. And then, you know, this is not for a macOS. There we go. So now it says Observable is only available iOS 17 or newer. So we need to actually make sure that this project is iOS 17 or newer. So let's go into the package. And then after the name, let me just paste this code in. So we want to add the platforms, and it should be iOS 17, macOS 14, tvOS 17, watchOS 10, and visualOS version 1. This is, so the observable right over should be available for all of those. Let me just see. Yes, so it just went away. It needed a little bit. So let's take a look at this error. So it says, capture of self with non-sendable type network observer in a sendable closure. It does not conform to the sendable protocol. Okay, so let's add that. And we are going to add at unchecked sendable. And that should fix it. There we go. And we are kind of done. But remember, this is a package. This is a separate module than your project. You need access to it. If you don't add any access keys right over here, you are going to use the default internal one. So this class is internal, the extension is internal. What this means is they are accessible only on this package. We want this public. So we want this accessible on your project. So all you have to do is just add public. And let's just add public to the variable is connected. We need access to it. Also, we need the initializer to be public. And then these two extensions should also be public. There we go. And basically, that's it. Now you will have access to the listen to network changes. You know, we are going to set it up as the initializer and also the is connected to just check if we are connected or not. Okay, so with all those changes, now it's time to save all of this. So what we are going to do, you know, we have only a local version of this. What I'm going to do is just right click on here and let's create new network observer remote. Make sure that you are logged in into one of your accounts, GitHub, whatever. If not, you will be notified and then you can just log in with Xcode. And then it should be public. It has to be public because otherwise you will not be able to download it to your project. Repository name is just fine. Let's create it. There we go. And let's see, not all the changes have been added. The changes that we did not commit were not added to our GitHub repository. Therefore, I want to select integrate. First of all, stage all changes. So all of the changes are staged, so they are ready to commit. And then click on commit right over here. And otherwise, you would need to stage all changes right over here at this button. And then let's just have initial commit. And then click on this arrow, chevron down arrow, and then commit and push. Just do it in one swoop. Okay, let's click on push over there. So we have committed our changes, pushed it up all the way to our GitHub repository. Now let's take a look at it. So let's go to repositories and then view on GitHub. Let's resize our window a little bit. And you see, we just committed with the initial commit with the capital letters is 7 minutes ago. And with the smaller case, it's just now. Okay, but still we can't actually download this till we tag our project. So let's do that. Let's go under our repositories, you select the main, and then this is our initial commit that we have created. Let's right click on it and add, or rather add, let's just tag the main right over here. It's much easier because it's the latest one. Okay, so tag, let's just call it 1.00, and let's create that. And you will see this tag right over here on the latest one. If you want to tag something else, that, but you should be using the late, you should be tagging the latest one. Okay, we tagged it. It's local, so what we need to do is just push the tags also, so include tags. We don't have any changes currently, but we must include the tags. So let's push that. There we go. And now switch to Safari. Let's refresh our browser. Now you see we have one release with one tag. So that's what we are going to use. Let's click on this code button, copy out the HTTPS, and now let's go back to not the actual Swift package, but the project that we had, you know, we just built the network observer right over here. Let's import this as a Swift package. So first of all, what I'm going to do is just select all and just comment it out. We can't comment it out. Well, I'm just going to do it manually, just like that. And then, of course, we are going to have some issues, you know, errors, all of that stuff. But what I'm going to do is just add our Swift package that we have created. Select your project, package dependencies, click on plus, and we just, remember, we copied out that URL. We're just going to paste it there. And yeah, let's add that package. Make sure that the target is selected, add the package. There we go. Now, all we need to do is just import this module, well, Swift package. And where do we need to do that? In two places. In the app file, right over here, to where we need the listen to network changes. So let's import and network observer, sorry, observer. And now this warning should go away, and indeed it did. And then on the content view where we are actually using our network observer. So let's import network observer. And now we should be able to access our environment. And of course, everything should work as expected. So let's test this out. Currently it's connected. That's fine because we are connected to the web. Let's turn off Wi-Fi. It should say disconnected. Indeed it does. Let's turn it on again. And after it just connected, it will change to connected. And that's how easy it is to create a Swift package for yourself to distribute in many, many projects or for others too. Now, if you did like this tutorial, go ahead and check out the link for the mentoring offer in the description.